Hi, and welcome to this demonstration of how to easily pause live video, playback, and export surveillance footage using iMeta Symphony 7. This tutorial takes place completely inside the Symphony Operator client. In this example, we have selected the Rolex left camera from the devices tree, and it is currently a live feed. The first thing we want to do is find the time period in which we want to playback. To do this, click on the timeline button at the top of the client to reveal the camera's timeline. Inside the timeline, you can see activity marked with purple lines and boxes and red bars. The purple lines indicate when motion has been detected within the video, and the red bars indicate alarms that have been triggered. We'll start by clicking on the section of the timeline where motion is first registered by the indoor people tracking video analytic, prior to the first alarm being triggered. By clicking on the timeline, the archive surveillance footage is quickly retrieved and ready for historical playback. You can see inside the pause video that people tracking has been triggered due to the blue lines encircling visitors to the store and a motion trail tracking their movements within the scene. By hovering over the video, a control toolbar will appear and allow you to press play and begin viewing this segment of video. As the video plays, we can see that one person is moving across the screen to a display case, and the tracking circle has turned red, indicating they have crossed a predetermined tripwire, setting an alarm. Then another person moves closer to another case and triggers another alarm. We've seen the first alarm being triggered within the video, and rather than click through the timeline, we can easily view the next motion detection by first pausing the video and using the navigation toolbar to jump forward. Be sure to click on the forward arrow with the exclamation symbol to reach the next motion detection. If we look back to the timeline, we can see the video jumped over the second alarm marker and to the next motion detection. To quickly jump back to the previous alarm, simply click on the back arrow that contains the bell icon in the navigation toolbar, as you can see here. Here we are moving the video back and forth to pinpoint the time frame in which we wish to export by making note of the time frame. Once we've located the appropriate start and end points to the video to be exported, bring the cursor back up to the timeline, right-click, and move down to Mark Export Start. Head farther down the timeline to your chosen endpoint, right-click again, and select Mark Export End. You can see now the two arrows in the timeline showing the time frame to be exported. Hover over the screen below to bring up the export icon in the top left corner of the video playback and click on it. The window that pops up will show details about the video, including start and end times, the format, and location the video is to be saved. Once the proper settings are selected, click Export. Depending on the size of the video and the format, exporting may take several moments to finish. When the export is complete, a completed message window will appear, as you can see here. To see where the video is saved, click Open Containing Folder. We are brought to the video and a text document saved with the exported video. This text document contains details about the video for chain of custody. Information in the text file includes when the video was exported, who exported it, and a video file MDS to ensure no one has tampered with evidence before it is presented. And now double-click on the video file anytime for a detailed review. Thank you for watching this video on how to pause live video, playback recorded footage, and export that footage using iMeta Symphony 7.